Hello students, in this video we are going to discuss about biological classification. Biological classification is the scientific procedure of arranging organisms into groups on the basis of their characteristics. There are several classification systems are developed time to time. Living organisms are classified into various type of kingdom system. Number one is two kingdom system, second one is three kingdom system, third one is four kingdom system, and the last one is five kingdom system. So students, first we are going to discuss about the two kingdom system. Two kingdom system was given by Linnaeus. According to two kingdom system, all the living organisms divided into two kingdoms. First kingdom is kingdom Plantae and the second one is kingdom Animalia. All those living organisms that shows resemblance with the plant are placed into a kingdom Plantae, and all those living organisms that shows resemblance with the animal are placed under kingdom Animalia. But this kingdom system have some drawbacks. So we are going to discuss drawbacks of two kingdom system. First one is, in this system photosynthetic and non-photosynthetic organisms are placed at one place. Their second drawback is, this system cannot be distinguished between prokaryotes and eukaryotes. In this system, unicellular and multicellular organisms placed together. It is difficult to place few organisms into plant or animal because they show features of both. For example, Euglena, it shows some features of plant and some features of animal. So, whether we place Euglena in this system. Next, we are going to discuss three kingdom system. Three kingdom system was given by Haeckel in 1866. According to this system, all the living organism grouped into a three kingdom. Haeckel introduces a new group that named as Protista, or we can also say as kingdom Protista, which comprises of only unicellular organisms. So, according to this system, all the living organisms divided into three groups. Number one is kingdom Protista, second one is kingdom Plantae, and the third one is kingdom Animalia. Next, we are going to discuss drawbacks of three kingdom system. Number one is, also in this system, prokaryotes and eukaryotes placed together. Fungi are grouped into plant, even they are heterotrophic in nature. Next, we are going to discuss four kingdom system. Four kingdom system was given by Copeland in 1956. Copeland created a separate kingdom Monera for unicellular prokaryotes. So, all the microscopic unicellular prokaryotes placed in Monera and all the unicellular eukaryotes placed in a kingdom Protista. So, according to this system, all the living organisms are divided into four kingdom. Number one is kingdom Monera. Kingdom Monera comprises of all the unicellular prokaryotes. It include bacteria, cyanobacteria, mycoplasma, etc. Next one is kingdom Protista. Kingdom Protista comprises of all the unicellular eukaryotes. Third kingdom is kingdom Plantae. Kingdom Plantae includes all the green plants. Plants are multicellular eukaryotic autotrophs with cell walls. And the last kingdom is kingdom Animalia. Animals belong to this kingdom. It includes all the multicellular eukaryotic heterotrophs without cell wall. Next, we are going to discuss drawbacks of four kingdom system. Still, fungus are placed in the kingdom Plantae. Instead, they are heterotrophic in mode of nutrition. So students, this is all about four kingdom system. Five kingdom system we will discuss in the next video. Thank you.